look like knots or bumps under the skin, and they affect 40 million Americans every year, most of them women. We are talking about varicose veins, and Dr. Greenberg with the Carolina Vein Specialist and Emily Berg joining us to continue our conversation from the segment you just saw where Emily Berg recently underwent treatment for her varicose veins. Dr. Greenberg, let's start with you. 40 million people. Mm-hmm. So it sounds like it's a pretty common issue.
Very common, and it affects at least 40% of women as they get older, particularly after the age of 45, we start to see a huge increase. And interestingly, the problem with it is that people have the assumption that varicose veins are only what's on the surface, but we see so many people who've come to us either by referral or by seeing some advertisement or something that notes that they've got symptoms without anything being on the surface to begin with. So even though varicose vein disease in most people's eyes has to do with what they see on the surface, the fact is so much of it's coming from the inside first before they even get surface veins.
Okay. Now, is surgery something that people do for cosmetic reasons, or is it actually causing some health problems?
Varicose veins actually can cause a lot of health problems, and particularly people will describe symptoms as heaviness, aching, throbbing, itching, burning, swollen ankles. A lot of people come to us because just they have cramps or restlessness to their legs at night, so they have trouble sleeping. But people who have jobs where they stand or sit for long periods, and interestingly, pregnancies, especially after the third, statistically, makes it worse. I have a patient who had 16 single pregnancies, and she told me that the third one was the doozy that caused her leg pain symptoms. So we know that there's a lot of genetic predisposition to this, but jobs where you're standing or sitting for prolonged periods really aggravates the problem.
Wow, and Emily, certainly want to get you in on this.
Yeah.
So why was surgery sort of the right thing for you?
Well, it got to the point where I wasn't able to play on the floor with my kid, and she's only 5 years old. So, you know, you want to have those experiences where you're pain-free and able to play, and I wasn't at that point anymore. It was feeling like my leg was going to explode in some parts of my leg. It just, the pressure was really, really uncomfortable. And there were times when I would feel that throbbing that Dr. Greenberg described. And, you know, the aching and throbbing you can deal with after a while, but when it starts to interfere with the things that really mean a lot to you in life, you go to your doctor and your doctor refers you to a specialist.
But overall, pleased with your decision?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. And full disclaimer, the bandage on my knee today has nothing to do with the surgery. That was my own clumsiness falling down this past weekend at the beach. But I have to say, and we mentioned this earlier, this bandage on my knee where I skinned my knee hurts more than any part of the procedure. Any part of it. I mean, it was really amazing to me how little discomfort there was. Before, during, and after.
And so I think people have the idea that it's their grandma's procedure, that the vein stripping, mm-hmm. which used to be, prior to the year 2000, used to be sort of the standard of care. And even in the last 15 years, it's been what they call thermal procedures, where they put a laser fiber or what they call an RF fiber that uses heat to generate to close the veins. But the problem with those procedures, it takes a lot of numbing and anesthesia on the leg to cool those things down, and then people still can have a lot of discomfort even afterwards. These newer technologies that have just come out in the last few years eliminates all the numbing symptoms, and we don't have to do any anesthesia anymore. It's amazing. And people go right back to work and can exercise. It's amazing what we can do now.
And there are fewer spots to heal also.
Absolutely. Well, thank you both for being here. We're out of time, but it's amazing to see how far we've come. And Emily, thank you for sharing such an intimate story with
us. Of course.
We appreciate it. Thank you.